The Mauritius Tourism Board is in Delhi today for a roadshow that's going to take four cities, Mumbai, Delhi, then we're going to Bangalore and to Chennai. There's a very special reason why we are here with more than 20 of our private sector operators. It is really to pass on the message of all the exciting things that one can do in Mauritius. Mauritius is well known in India. We've been here for more than 20 years. We receive Indian tourists for more than 20 years. I think, however, that we're still very, very much known as a luxury destination for the beach and luxury accommodation. We are that. We do fine gastronomy, fine dining, beautiful five-star and four-star accommodation. But I think the message here today is that there's so many more activities beyond the beach that one can do in Mauritius, and this is of particular interest to the Indian traveler. So much you can do as a family in Mauritius. You can do the nature parks, you can do the attraction parks where you can perhaps interact with the big cats. We've done a lot of effort in conservation, so we are one of the countries which, unfortunately, after the end of the dodo, we've been now very, very conscious of ecotourism and preserving our wildlife. So, for example, you can visit Îles et Grettes, where there's an educational trip with your family and the kids to see how we've protected the environment and how we've saved so many endangered species to bring them to their wildlife state, such as the pink pigeon, the giant tortoises, the Mauritian kestrel, etc. So families will have lots to do, but there's also a lot to do for the adrenaline seeker. I've seen some Indian adrenaline seekers come to Mauritius, and on the day of their arrival themselves, they've already booked a skydive, and skydiving from Mauritius is pretty spectacular. It's obviously done according to international norms, so you're very safe, but it is a beautiful, extraordinary experience. Then you can do some zip lining, you can do some of the best trails and treks in the world, and you can even choose to do a submarine trip in Mauritius. In fact, we see that the Indian traveler is amongst the keenest outdoor activity seekers. So the message today to the Indians that want to travel to Mauritius to visit the country is yes, come to Mauritius, where more than 90% of the room stock is 4 and 5 star accommodation. Come and visit our beautiful beaches, but also come and do our inland activities. A couple of things, we've been very lucky this year. For example, TripAdvisor has voted Mauritius as having one of the top 10 beaches in the world. Le Petit Futé from France has voted one of our roads, the Macondé Road, as one of the top 10 scenic roads in the world again. The UK Telegraph has voted Mauritius for having one of the top 10 street food in the world. We do fine gastronomy, but also we do very fine street food. And recently, we've had Expedia vote us as one of the most interesting island destinations for weddings and honeymoons, also by the World Travel Awards. As a confluence of cultures, Mauritius has a lot of diversity, and I invite the Indian traveler, the one who's looking for a cultural experience, to come and visit our country. Now, there are two UNESCO World Sites in Mauritius. There are also two UNESCO Intangible Heritage, some of which are linked to our Indian culture and others to our African and European cultures. There's a lot of diversity when it comes to food. You've got Indian food if you want to be a little bit, if you want to be home away from home, but you also have very exclusive and high-end fine dining with European, with French influence. The fine wines of France are there. The very nice South African wines are also to be found in abundance in Mauritius. And then if you want to get some exotic taste, you can try the Creole cuisine. Very beautiful. This year, Mauritius has started the celebration of our 50 years of independence, which is on the 12th of March, 2018. And there's an exciting calendar of events that is scheduled with an event almost every single week until that date. So I invite you to come. We start with the Diwali Mela very shortly. Then we have the Festival Creole, the Creole Festival, which shows the Creole side of Mauritius. Then we have a very exciting open-air street performance and visual mapping event in December, early December, called Polui by Nature. This is a sunset in Mauritius. With your family, with your loved one, there's nothing more beautiful than coming and witnessing a Mauritian sunset on the beach with a sundowner. This one is a picture taken by a very well-known. This one is a picture taken by a very well-known French diver, a very well-known French diving photographer, who has caught some of the most amazing underwater sights in our lagoons for you to capture. Look at the beautiful state of the coral. This is red coral, and look at the diver who's diving there. I would like you to see here the practitioners of a very exciting sport called kite surfing. You can see the kite and you can see them surf. You can do incredible loops with this kind of sport. Mauritius has one of the world's top three spots for kite surfing. It's called One Eye, and we host the World Championship, the GKA World Championship there every single year. This man is a self-made artist. He's called Pem. He collects driftwood that drifts on the through the sea to Mauritius, and he makes incredible sculptures out of them. Finally, I'd like you to see, I would like to see a marvel of the world that you can see in Mauritius. It's called the chamarelle. It's the seven-colored earth. In fact, the earth of Mauritius, because of the different levels of iron, oxidizes at different colors, and you have this amazing seven-colored earth. Somewhere else in Mauritius, you have the same formation, but with 24-colored earth in the country. And really, it is worth a visit. This is a view of a dependency of Mauritius, an autonomous island called Rodrigues, and you can see the cliff-like structures, which gives you to very private coves where you can have free time for you and with your family or your loved ones. Really an absolute must to visit. Several daily flights from Mauritius, very easy to do. You don't need a visa to go to Rodrigues, it's a dependency of Mauritius. And I must leave you with our main offering, the beaches and the beautiful Sea of Mauritius. This is a dream destination. So I look forward to seeing you there, and certainly for those who have not visited Mauritius before, this is the best time to do it. And those who have, I invite you to come back again. Thank you.